Can you check the turkey, please?
Yep. Hang on. I gotta find my poker.
Did you turn this oven on?
Yeah, it's been on for a couple hours.
It's not warm. Uh-oh.
Great.
Yeah, it's on. It's like 400 degrees, but it's not warm in there. I don't know what's going on. Uh-oh. Time for a new one, maybe. Frig sakes. Okay, so in case you didn't know, our oven did take a crap there in August, apparently. But I just didn't run out and grab one right away because we had the barbecue and stuff, you know. So it's sort of a nice time to barbecue and stuff outside. And so the old oven, she was making some snapping, fizzling noises and stuff, so we unplugged her, actually, and popped the breaker downstairs just in case. So I didn't even want to bother hooking her back up to try her, because, you know, she's had her life. It's pretty old, so we went down to, over to Future Shop this morning, and picked up another one, a nice new one. And this is an LG, one of them split model-y ones. So it's got like, it's not a picture there, but it's got like the oven like this, and then it's got like one oven there and then another bigger oven on the bottom, right? So we're gonna get this hauled out of here and rip the cardboard and stuff off outside and haul her inside. Hopefully she works good. All right, so there she is out of the truck, and it was funny because you can see there pretty clear as day in three languages that says do not clamp. Well, when they brought it out, they had one of them big forklifts here with those great big paddle things on the side that clamps it, picks it up, and drives away with it, right? Well, yeah, that's great. It says do not clamp, I think, on all sides, and yeah, that's what they did, so I don't know, whatever. There's grabber handles there and stuff. So we're gonna cut this thing open here, and kind of feels to me in there like there's a lot more packaging in there than the stove. So I bet you this will be half the size by the time we're done. So anyways, let's chop her open. Washer machine, not a dryer, or whatchamacallit. Oh, look at that, eh? Sweet. I did do it the wrong way. This is like Christmas time!
It is Christmas time.
Sweet. Oh, yeah. Duh. Tape all stuck to me and everything now. Come on. This is a pretty wicked cardboardy thing. Pretty neat. And look at that. 129! Okay, I think we are good to get her inside.
Okay, so let's just have a quick looky at this out here while she's still out here. It's this. So there's the average kilowattage per year. It's pretty high, you know. That's, I guess, if you have her cranked on the whole time. I don't know. And I think it's taped shut. So maybe I'll wait till I get her inside so they don't flop open on us. But you can see the two smaller and a... you know, one there, right? So it's what she wanted, but it's got no storage drawer on the bottom for your stuff, but we'll have to figure that out. But anyways, let's get her pulled inside here. All right, so we got her in. I haven't turned the juice on yet, but she's looking good. There's the two Deweys, and there's the top Dewey. It's small, eh? But for all that she really gets into doing, that's, she says that's be good. So then there's the bigger side there. So we just got her in, letting her climatize a little bit, and you can see the airflowy thing back there, eh? So and it's got the burner thingy there. So it's gonna be different, but anyways, let's go down. Maybe we'll hit the power on, but we won't fire this thing right up yet until she warms up a bit, because that's actually probably okay now. It's a bit cool still, so we'll let her warm up a bit. But there's all your controllers, you know, and your display thingies and stuff. I don't know how it all works yet, but she'll be a workout for us, that's for sure. But an upper oven, lower oven, there you go. So you just touch and go, I guess, or whatever, you know. So pretty sweet. Let's go crank the power up. Okay, so it says press clock to set time. Okay. Enter clock time. What tech time is it? 1:31. Press start. Start. What did that say? Press start or enter. Hmm? Oh, start here. Clock is set. Sweet. Now what? It says PF on them thingies. That's not good. The upper light. Yeah. Lower light. Yeah. Upper self-clean. I don't think I want to push that yet. So I'm presuming this is red element. Okay. Oh, she clicked on. Oh, it's getting hot. Sweet! Actually it works, oi?
I hope so.
For that price, eh? Holy.
Well, no wonder it's so expensive. It's a convention.
Yeah, $1,500. But it works good. Let's turn this one on now. Select. What'd that do? What'd that do, Tubes? Sweet. H5, what does that mean? Burner there. And this is an even bigger one. Holy. What about this one here, I guess? How do you select though? I don't get that. Low. Oh, that's that one there. It's warming up. Look at the size of them. Oh, that didn't stay on very long, did it? Uh-oh. That is a big mother. Holy. I think there's other thingies in there, but I don't know. She'll have to figure that out. I don't know what it is. These ones still say it's hot 5, I guess. That's what that means. Hot 5. H5 or something. Let's let this one go a minute here. Don't you just want to stick your hand on that? Ow! Thank you. What is this gonna flash up? H5. Hot 5 maybe? I don't know. I don't really want to turn the oven part on because I don't know how to work it. Oven, lower light. Why is that staying on? Maybe it goes off after a bit, I don't know. Is there light here? I don't think they give you a light under here, which is kind of dumb. Oh well. But, what else is in here now? Oh boy, this is... I'm going to let her figure this out, because I got no idea. Got no idea with this stuff. But, anyway, it seems to work. Let's try this one, actually. Just sucking the juice back. That one didn't turn on, why not? What'd I do wrong there? Warming zone. Oh, that's what this is. It's not really super hot, hot. I don't understand the select thing, though. I don't know. But anyways, she seems to work. Sorry for the fuzzies in and out and stuff. Just doesn't like the shiny in the... Holy. Thanks, buddy. Anyways, there we go. Well, that's it for today, too. That's all we got into, was just going down to get that oven. And it kind of sucked a bit because I had to... we went over to the Future Shop here, and I guess they don't stock anything. So they got the stuff on display, but they don't actually have one there you can take home with you. So it's kind of useless. So I says to the girl there, I'm like, well, is there somewhere I can go to get this? Because, like, I need this thing today, you know? I don't want to wait for freaking 3 days for them to come ship it up here. Like, frig that idea. So she's like, oh, yeah, you can go down to the warehouse. I'm like, okay, that's fine. It wasn't too far away. It was probably about the equivalent of me driving to Princess Auto, so about 45 minutes or so. And go to this place. There's no signs, no nothing. I'm like, I hope this is the right place. So there's like a guard shacky house there. So we go into the guard shacky's there, and he comes out, and what did he say to me? What are you here for? I'm like, I just purchased an oven from the Future Shop there, and they sent me down here to pick it up. Oh, okay. So we looked at my receipt, and he says, they had like a great big, like, it's one of these big warehouses, eh? Or those freaking, like, tractor trailer trailers everywhere, and there's, you know, like, about 3,000 loading bay doors, and this great big, huge mother of a building, probably the size of the cemetery. And he says, just follow these cones all the way around the far side there, and then someone will see you back there and tell you where to go. So I went through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 security guards until I finally got to the door. So I'm like, okay. So I backed in, and he's like, you know, can I see your receipt? I'm like, yeah, sure. So he got the guy to bring it up, you know, with the crushing pallet fork things that you're not supposed to move those things with, but whatever. And backed the truck up there, threw it in, and took off. That was it. So it worked pretty good, you know, but kind of stupid that you can't get it right at the Future Shop, you know. Like, if they're going to sell something, you should have at least one of them there, you know. Yes, I know it probably takes up a lot of room if you got one of everything you got there, but I mean, if you can't supply it to your customer as soon as they're there to buy it, that's not very good. I don't like that. You know, like, what the heck? So that'd be like someone showing up here for a funeral and I say, I don't have any dirt here today to throw on top of you, so sorry, you're going to have to come back on Tuesday. That's kind of rude, you know, like, they shouldn't be doing that, but it seems to be like a lot of places are doing that. Like, the place you go in town here, the Sleep Country Canada bed place, they don't have anything in stock. You got to order it and they'll deliver it to you, like, oh, we're going to have it there in 2 days or whatever, in 72 hours or 85,000 hours or whatever. It's like, I'm here now with my trailer and my truck and stuff and whatever, you know, I want to get this while I'm here. Like, holy frig. But anyways, it was a pretty nice day for a ride down to the big warehouse there, and not much else going on. So, you know, we thought, might as well do that today. So, got a pretty expensive oven, though. It's a good oven by the looks of things, though. But that's what she wanted, was one of those doubly layer ones there, you know. But instead of heating up one great big huge freaking mother space, you just have to heat up the one little small space, right? So, you know, if you're only doing like a lasagna or something, you don't need that great big huge mother oven. But it looks like the bottom one will still take a fair big turkey too if you need it, right? So if I can fit in there, the big turkey will fit in there, but but anyways, I do have plans for that other oven. We're going to get a towel of some sort. Better not use one of her new ones. We're going to get a towel and see if we can clean her up a bit, because I did notice it was pretty scrubbly there, eh? That was actually supposed to be one of those self-cleaning ovens that never frickin' worked. And Sarah doesn't like using that oven cleaning stuff, eh? Because it's pretty frickin' wicked, so... pretty wicked stuff. Because, you know, you're cleaning your oven with this crap, and then... Let's throw the turkey in there or the roast beef in there for dinner tonight. It's like, no, I don't think that's such a good idea. So that's why the door kind of looks all scrubbled and stuff like that. Because, you know, once that stuff gets baked in there, it's hard to get off. But the it was supposed to be self-clean too, and it works. Like, the self-clean worked, but it never actually worked. So I don't know. That's just a selling thing. That is, oh, self-cleaning. You don't have to clean it. Yeah, you do. If you like using that... freaking degrimery stuff in the bottle there. It's freaking pretty wicked stuff, though. But keep away from those chemicals as much as you can, eh? Because you're putting that in your oven, you're putting that in your food. I mean, you got to really be careful, you know. If it's strong enough to strip that stuff off, imagine what it's doing to your intestines. Mm-hmm. And the rest of you. But anyways, that is it for today. So did I finish mentioning about what I was going to do with that old stove? I don't think I did. If I didn't, I already lost track of that, so... yeah, I'm going to take a towel and try to clean it up a bit with the backhoe and the thumb and see how well we can do cleaning it up. So, I'm kind of thinking that it's probably not going to go too well. But actually, no, my plan is to, you know, play around a bit with it and then squash it down to scrap metal size, because the place where I take my scrap metal in, if they see that, As a stove coming in, yes, it is metal, but they'll charge you $25 per appliance to get rid of it. So if you squash her down to why they can't recognize it kind of thing, and it's just scrap metal, you tell them, then they don't know any different. So, but what a scam that is, though. What a scam. I was out there one day with a load of scrap metal, and I knew about this $25 to get rid of each appliance thingy. And yes, they do have an area set aside away from the scrap metal for that, but I'm getting up there up to the top of the hill where I dump the stuff, and I see a buddy with a little skid steer, Bobcat skid steer, grabbing these things, squashing them all up, and then throwing them in the scrap metal bin. It's like, wait a minute, you just charged people to get rid of that, and now you're just putting it in the same pile as the scrap metal. So that ticked me off a bit, so every time I have one of these now, I just squash it up, you know, into scrap metal bits. So that's the way she's gonna be. So, but don't know when we're going to get to that. One of these days, probably this week, we'll have to get rid of that, and probably going to have almost enough to take a load in, so it might be an hour day. So, but anyways, that is it for today. I don't think there was anything else on top of my head. No. I can't remember anyways. But anyways, if you guys have a good one, it's not a super long, huge video. Sorry, I apologize today, but once again, like, you know, we're not down in the garage doing stuff right now, so holidaying, I guess you'd say, right? We're holidaying, so. But anyways, that's it. Have a good night, tubes, and we'll talk at you later.